Hi, and welcome to episode 5 of Spring Vlog. It's a day later than planned, but it's an extra long episode to make up for it. So without further ado, come and find out what we did.
It's Wednesday morning, and guess where we're going? Our favourite place, Island Near Hyde. We're just going to do a quick visit to here. I'm just going to stop because the wind is blowing and I don't want the camera to go funny. We're just going to go here for a little while and go back for a sort of late leisurely lunch. And then this evening we're heading off to Blacksall Common near Snape to hopefully capture some nightjar sounds.
The BBC have set up underwater cameras at Island Mere to capture the sticklebacks which breed in the water there. Bramrin had to make do with waving her vlog camera over the fence.
Everyone had gone bitten mad in Island Near Hyde, so we decided to change our plan and walk around towards the North Wall. And on the way, we saw a stoat doing something. We're not sure what it was doing yet. We think it was catching baby rabbits and feeding them to its young, but we're not quite sure. Everyone else seemed to be there filming at the same time, but it's pretty cool.
Standing here watching the sand martins. They overwinter in South Africa and one of the first migrants to arrive here, and they nest in enormous colonies, and there's one just outside the RSPB centre, which is amazing, and we've got a platform where we can watch them and can really see them going in and out of their holes.
Show us what you brought.
We've now seen Spoonbill, officially.
And does this mean we're going to actually get to see the Spoonbill?
Yep. On Friday, I'm going to use this to summon up the Spoonbill.
We've just been trying to find out about green woodpeckers, because they're missing off our list. And when we've been before, we've seen quite a few of them. We've heard a couple today in the distance, but not seen any. And the lady from the RSPB was just telling us that there may or may not be some. Seem to know really very much. But she did say that lesser spotteds no longer come to Minsmere, which is very sad. Never seen a lesser spotted ever, so, but obviously not going to see one of those this week.
We don't have to move very far to see some wildlife, because just outside our front door we have a little hole in the beam and there are coltits going in and out, so there are obviously babies in there because we can hear them.
This evening we headed to Blacksall Common near Snape on the hunt for a very unusual heathland bird, the nightjar.
We ventured into civilization. We needed some supplies, so Dad's just gone into Wesselton Village Store to get, what's he getting?
Banana.
Milk.
And possibly cream.
because they are essential things for every healthy appetite. We're also slightly ridiculously looking for house sparrows, starlings and collared doves to add to our weak bird list, because you don't get them in Minsmere or any of the other places we're going. So whenever you go anywhere with houses, you look for different kinds of birds. Haven't seen any of them yet, but hopefully.
No cream, I'm afraid, dear.
Oh no.
Oh.
What we got then?
We got Elmley.
Oh.
No. Bananas and milk.
Three shops later, we've got cream. This is probably about as close as we're going to get to seeing a nightjar.
We're just walking in some woods at Blaxall Common, and we noticed that every 50, 100 yards or so, there are these big piles of something that look like long barrows in between the trees, and we were trying to figure out what they are. So if anybody knows, perhaps you can tell us. They're quite huge and they're covered with bracken and sometimes trees, so they've been there a long time. We just wondered how they got there and why they'd be put there.
There's a fantastic badger set there. The badgers have obviously made a burrow right in the mound there. Very unusual for this sort of forest because they just don't like pine forest normally, but obviously he's taken advantage of that.
We've just found what looks like a new one of these strange mounds beginning, and it looks like they just clear the ground and make a big pile and just leave it to rot down, so it's just like a massive compost heap.
Just craning our necks to look at goldcrests, which are adorable little birds, tiny, but always hang around at the tops of trees. You can kind of hear them better than see them. They're making a very high-pitched kind of zit sound. And there's loads of them. They're feeding young, I think. And I can't tell the difference between the young and the adults, but very difficult to spot. Not only are they goldcrests, but there's a cuckoo in the background. Just snipped up the road to snake maltings for a little pre-nightjar amble bit around the reed beds around here, see what we can see. And we've just seen a starling and a collared dove, which add to our total. It's 5 to 8. It's just starting to lose the light a little bit, and we parked nearly in the same place at Blaxall Common. And this is where we came last year, and we heard nightjars and a nightingale and a cuckoo. And we've already heard a cuckoo, so that's a good sign. So we're going to trek into the heathland and try and find ourselves some nightjars. This particular area is perfect for nightjars. It's got sort of open heathland over there, sort of scattered trees, but it's right on the edge of some, well, on this side there's some fairly dense deciduous woodland. The nightjars kind of spend a lot of their time in the woods and sleeping in the daytime, but then they come out into the open heathland at dusk and sort of hunt for small insects and moths and things like that, which they catch on the wing. A bit like swallows, but bigger. And they only hunt at sort of, you know, a particular time of evening. So I doubt we'll see any, and even if we do, it'll be too dark to film. But you can usually hear them in places like this, in this part of the country, so fingers crossed.
It was too sandy down there.
Takes the high road to avoid walking in the sand, which is really hard work, but good for the thighs. Well, we've had a couple of nice views of a yellowhammer, which is very elusive and camera shy as always, and we're pretty sure that we've heard a couple of short bursts of nightjar's sound, so we're hopeful. But it's still quite light, so we've got a bit of a waiting game.